Okay, Microsoft Sway is a presentation software, and you get there by going to sway.office.com. And we're just going to open up one of these templates that was provided. And you see automatically, it doesn't just look like a boring slide. It's making choices for you based on a style, and it's doing things like panning pictures. You have to scroll to the right to get through the story. And you can customize these things, which is what we're going to go over in a second. So if I go into the upper right-hand corner and I click these three dots, it's going to bring me back to the main screen. And we're just going to start a blank sway so that we can talk through how to build it and then what these different design choices mean. I'm going to title this Life by the Lake. And what you're looking at here, they're calling a card. And so we can add a background picture to the card. We can style it a little bit up here. And when we're done with that, you go down to the plus to add your next piece of content. And first we're going to add a background picture. Sway wants to search Bing for your pictures, but just to make sure I'm just showing my own content, I'm just going to grab a picture off my hard drive. And so I clicked on my device and I put a little picture here. And notice that when you're putting these pictures on, you can't really tell what it's going to look like. And that's because there's a lot of flexibility in how these are displayed. So you put the content on here first, and then you look at how you want it to be shown. So I made my title card here, and it has the picture with it, and I want to have some more content below it. You just do this by adding another card. So let's add a header card. And you see there's only one heading here. After you add a heading, then the choice for a heading 2 will appear. But since there's only one, it doesn't even make sense to offer a heading 2. Now we're going to say that the first thing that you want to do is to learn the different types of knots. So I'm going to go down to the green plus sign underneath this card and add my next card. So I'm going to add some text below it. And Microsoft Sway wants to treat this text differently than the header. So it's going to give you another box and you're going to have a fresh menu of options on how to style the text. And they have these kind of standard text styling options here, but if you'll notice, they aren't called bold and they aren't called italic because what they're going to do is going to change depending on the style that you choose. So if I do want to emphasize learn how to make a loop, because I feel that's important, I'm going to select that, but it's not necessarily going to make it just bold. So I'm going to want to add a new group because this is going to be kind of a new thought, but we're going to do a comparison group just to show you how some different functions work that they have. In this comparison card, you can see these cards are pre-built for the functionality that it's going to be, and it's waiting for a comparison. And in order to do that, yeah, for some reason to put them below, but all you really have to do is just drag them up. So we're going to pull this image card into that comparison, and we're going to pull this one into there. And you can give them a caption if you want. It's hard to tell how this caption is going to end up until you preview the sway. See, this one's just water right now. How about water with islands? Now we've made a little sway. There's obviously other design types. You can embed some code. There's another video on how to do that. You can search for content and put it in there. But right now, the point of this video is just to show you how to create one and then show you how to style it. So we have enough content to go into design. So I go in the upper left-hand corner and I click on design. And first it's going to bring you to a preview of it. I didn't make any of these choices here. This sway just chose for me and it just thought it was a good starting point. So you can scroll to the right. Here's the background image and my title. And you can see that it applies different styling to the header. This is the header, and this is a text box that I put in the same group as the header. And I emphasize this text, so it didn't just make it bold. It made it bold and red. And you don't really know that until you look at the styling. And this is a comparison. So these stories are supposed to be interactive, and on each of these you can left click to see the caption, or you can click on the slider and compare the image. Maybe those aren't the best two images to compare, but you see what I'm doing, right? Now, if you want to style this differently, go in the upper right-hand corner and click on Styles. And this, depending on your opinion, this is either the greatest thing or the worst thing about Sway. This is the main dashboard for styling your content, and it wants you to basically choose a design, and it's going to apply it for you. So if you're used to PowerPoint, where you control exactly where everything goes on the screen, control the font size and the color, you just make it look perfect, that's not what Microsoft is going for here. This is just saying, hey, how do you kind of want me to make your story look? You can also scroll through it vertically or horizontally, or you can make it a slideshow. But Sway really isn't meant to be a slideshow. It's not even really meant to stand in front of and talk to an audience about. It's just kind of meant to tell a story that you scroll through. So I would either do vertical or horizontal. We'll just change it to vertical so we can see something different. And it's going to give you a preview on the left-hand side. So if you scroll down this, you see what has changed. Okay, one of the things that Sway can do is actually pick your color palette from an existing picture. So you see, if I left-click on this image, it's actually the one that you're seeing on the left. If you left-click on it, you notice all these palettes just changed based on colors that were picked from this image. We'll pick one of these, and it's going to style everything for us. And so that's one option for styling, but if we go back, let's look at the pre-selected options. These previews are trying to tell you what they're going to do. So if we go down to this option, what this is telling you, let's left-click on it, and it's going to put a red block behind it. And it's going to make your fonts a serif font, so it's not going to have that extra kind of a Times New Roman looking pieces on the end of the letters. It's just going to be a straight font. And it's going to left align things. If you notice that these characters are left aligned as opposed to being in the middle. And this one here is just going to put kind of an artistic frame around it. And we're going to play with one more. So you see Sway's making a lot of choices for you. And this is either making it really easy to make a presentation or it's just making it frustrating for you and you should use PowerPoint. So once you have this looking the way that you want it, to share it, just go in the upper right-hand corner and click Share. And this will give you different options on how to send it out. So if you're using this through Office 365, if you have a paid account, then you can send it to those in your organization. So this will keep it locked down and it's not available to the public. But if you want to open it up, you can make it available to anyone with the link and you would just send this link out to whoever you want. You can do it in an email, you could put it in social media, you could embed it in a website. So if you left click on Get Embed Code, it's going to give you code like this that's meant to be copied and pasted into the source of, say, a blog or another website. And so those are the different ways to share a Sway. So I hope that was helpful. If you like this video and you want to see others like it, please click in the lower right-hand corner. And if you want notifications when the new videos come out, you can click on that little picture of a bell. Thanks.